Hey, my name's Parth, and predictably, after having covered Newton's first and second laws of motion, today we're going to be talking about Newton's third law of motion. But I'm going to be trying to explain it to you in 1 minute. By the way, if you haven't already, check out my previous videos for Newton's first and second law. Check them out up here, or click the links in the description below. Also, let me know in the comments down below if there are any physics ideas you'd like me to try and explain in 1 minute, and I'm going to give myself this challenge. And please stick around after the 1 minute explanation for my weekly question of the week. If you don't know what that is, stick around. Anyway, enough chit-chat, let's put 1 minute on the clock. And let's get going. Newton's third law of motion is often stated as saying that every action has an equal and opposite reaction, but this doesn't quite capture the nuances of the law. A better way to state Newton's third law would be to say that if object 1 exerts a force on object 2, then object 2 exerts an equal and opposite force on object 1. This way, there's no confusion about what force is acting on what object. Now, in this diagram, we've got two balls colliding. The first ball exerts a force F to the right on the second ball, and so the second ball also exerts a force F to the left on the first ball. So, in this diagram, why don't the forces just cancel each other out? Well, it's because they're acting on different objects. This is the key. Each object only has one force acting on it. We should also know that if the second ball didn't exert an equal and opposite force on the first ball, there'd be no net forces acting on the ball, so by Newton's first law, it would just continue to travel at the same speed in the same direction. It would go through the second ball. It's actually the reaction force that causes the first ball to bounce back upon colliding. And that, guys, is Newton's third law, or at least the basics, explained in 1 minute. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, then please leave a thumbs up and feel free to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. What I do is I make fun physics videos, though I don't have to try too hard because physics is already fun. Guys, hit that bell button as well if you want to see more physics content. You'll be notified every time I upload if you do. And don't forget to let me know down in the comments below any area of physics you want me to try and cover in a minute. You guys have already given me some amazing ideas in the first law video and the second law video, but please keep them coming. You guys are smashing it. Anyway, let's move on to the weekly question of the week. I promised you it was coming, so here it is. Now, for those of you that don't know, I used to make a lot of vlogs while I was at university, and every vlog would contain the weekly question of the week. In a weekly question of the week, I would basically ask you guys a question to hopefully help you reflect a little bit, maybe on life, maybe on yourself, maybe on something that you've been doing recently. Just a question that would hopefully trigger some interesting thoughts. And I'm bringing it back to my videos. So here is this week's weekly question of the week. What is something that you learned recently that genuinely made you excited about what you were learning? What's the last thing that you learned that you actually enjoyed learning? Not just learning for the sake of learning, but like, you learned something and it made you go, wow, this is really cool, I want to do more of this. Let me know down in the comments below what it is for you. It doesn't have to be academic, by the way. Like, for me, the most recent thing that I learned that I really, really enjoyed was actually earlier on today at work. I've been learning to use Adobe Premiere Pro, which is an editing software, and I've been doing this at work, and the thing that I learned today that I really, really enjoyed learning was about color grading footage. Now, color grading is when you take some footage and mess around with the colors in its most basic form to make it look like what you want it to look like, to fit the needs of your project. In my case, I take raw footage that looks like this, and I turn it into this. So, all right, I'm not very good at it yet, but that's what I'm learning. I'm learning how to color grade. And the reason I enjoyed learning about it today was that before I knew anything about color grading, it felt like such an inaccessible process almost. It felt like people who knew how to color grade knew the secret that I really wanted to be in on. And the reason for that is because I really like the look of nice looking footage. So I was learning the basics of color grading, such as how to manipulate the footage and to try and get as much out of it as possible. So that's the most recent thing that I learned that I really enjoyed learning about. What is it for you? Let me know in the comments below. Anyway, with that being said, this video is now getting too long, so I'm gonna stop talking. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye 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 bye.